And we're back here on BRGY. This time, Phi, iba naman yung game or yung activity natin.
Kinakabahan talaga ako sa mga
naman.
Game.
Naman! Ito naman, magpo-focus naman tayo kasi sa buhay mo sa teatro, pelikula, at TV, of course. So, syempre, susubukan natin ang creativity mo in our next activity. Okay, so ito naman, kailangan mo lang bigyan ng title yung three different categories. Theater, TV, and film. And not just any title though, it's about your life, yung buhay mo, in those okay. three categories. G? Get? Okay. Diba, pwede naman, for example, film, like yung sa beginning of the episode, Life of Phi. Ganon, diba? Because it's a play on Life of Phi. So here is your...
Okay.
Oh, okay, okay. So let's start with theater naman.
Okay.
Okay, let's see. Now it's time for the reveal. Ah, iba na to. Iba na tayo. Bakit naman yun ang title mo for your theater life?
Feeling ko kasi, kailangan ko i-remind yung sarili ko na iba na siya.
Yeah.
Na parang, kasi sometimes, nahihirapan pa din akong i-accept and fully embrace that
change.
I'm an actor.
Yeah.
Parang medyo matagal ko bago na fully embrace na I'm an actor. Whenever people would introduce me na, ah, si Phi, actor yan, ganyan.
So, ito naman, I'm very curious. Do you have a specific favorite theater show that you've done before? Or a favorite role specifically that you've done?
Actually, dalawa.
Dalawa.
Yes. Yung memorable for me is una, Mula sa Buwan.
Oh.
Yes, Mula sa Buwan. So yun, it's memorable for me because it's such a fun show to do. Such a fun show to do. And also the character I played there is Rosanna. The character Rosanna is traditionally played by a woman. And it's the first time for a queer actor to play
yeah.
and then have it like, gender bending. And the second one is Young Anthony in Ang Huling El Bimbo. It's memorable because I think it's one of the hardest role I've ever done physically and emotionally because oh my god yung sayaw doon sa show na yon. And also it's hard parang ang specific kasi ng pagiging part ni Young Anthony ng LGBTQIA+ community.
All right. So now for our second category, it is TV. So if you were to have, let's say, your own teleserye, what would the title be? All right. Perfect. You're ready. So let's see. Ano kaya? Ay! Sa aking mga
hands?
Wow! Bakit may question mark? Sorry, wait. Explain mo muna.
Okay. Gusto ko kasi yung ang tawag dito, sa aking mga kamay. It was an old movie. Tapos they turned it into a series, the Catleya Killer.
See, so coming from theater naman, you then segued into TV. So how did that happen? You know, did you decide to start auditioning for TV shows or were you scouted or how did that happen?
I was scouted. After Rock of Ages, I think it's the show that really opened a lot of doors for me. Napanood ako ng isang director doon, si Direk Ricky Rivero, and then he casted me in a show. Tapos during that time, napanood din ako ni Antoinette Hadaunes, ito Net. Tapos she is casting me sa Otwall, but I was doing this other show. So hindi parang but parang ayaw ganyan. Thankfully natapos na yung show na yon. Tapos tumawag sila ulit. Sakto na parang pwede ka na ba?
And imagine, like you said, you first had to decline because you weren't available. But they were persistent and they called back saying, "Are you available now? Pwede ka na ba?" After, ikaw na. You are the moment. No, but of course now let's go to our third category. Last but definitely not least, we have film.
Okay.
Ayan. Ay, bilis! Okay.
This one is simple.
Yeah. Okay. Fluid. Bakit naman?
Actually, this is the title. I based it sa isang play that was written by Sir Floy Quintos, one of my favorite writers, playwrights here in the Philippines. Fluid. Gusto ko yon because, in a way, my journey from theater to TV to movie is.
Fluid.
It's so easy. And I think, just like the water, it mixes everything. The discipline na nakuha ko sa theater and the skill that I got from TV.
But now, speaking of film, you've done a show and you've worked with great names like Nadine and James. But are any big names that you would want to work with in a movie?
With our young stars, I really, really want to work with Miggy Jimenez and Elijah Canlas. Yeah. So, sabi ko, parang I want to be in a scene with them. Yon. Tapos, other big stars. Of course, sana makatrabaho natin those great actors, si Ate V, si Ate Shawi, Nora Honor.
No, but of course, really quickly, since you were talking about fluid and how things just came so very fluid to you, baka naman you have maybe an advice or any learnings that you would like to share with our BFAM when it comes to seamlessly going through trying different things and becoming a versatile not only an actor, but a versatile artist in anything that they do.
Para sa akin, you really have to live your most authentic self. I know it's coming from a place of privilege because not everybody naman can,
has that privilege to
be themselves. Of course, there's so many things
factors,
that goes with it.
Yeah.
There's so many factors, parang family and your environment, management and everything, diba? Pero para sa akin kasi, yun talaga siya. You live your most authentic life and your most authentic self because at the end of the day, the characters that you're portraying are real people.
Very wise. No, it's very, very beautiful. I love it. So, of course, Bifa, malapit na tayo sa last act ng kwentuhan natin with Phi. I know. Sad. Gusto mo extend natin?
Oo, pwede po ba?
No, pero aalamin pa natin kay Phi ang mga future plans niya. So, let's find out sa pagbabalik ng BRGY.
Yay!
Hello BPAM, I'm Dasi Nayores. Ang first goal ko para sa 2024 ay magkaroon ako ng teleserye. Or maybe movie. Hindi natin alam, pero ayun yung pinaka first goal ko. Hola, hey, mabuhay!